Balair Balair, it's Roger B, Club Fitzwilliam, Malia Keir. Like Mortis Senior, Squash Nahira. The Honor Hosarum, Beg and Shah. That was that Fodger that got dinner. Boom. Welcome to Fitzwilliam. Lawn Tennis Squash Club in Dublin. The Irish Senior National Championships, which is going to be on this evening and tomorrow and on Sunday, with the finals on Sunday night. And it's a joy to be back with live squash and live streaming after 2 years of absence. It's felt even strange for me coming into Fitzwilliam. It's so long since I've been here. The first game here is Sean Murphy from Mount Pleasant Club in Dublin, and Nick Woods from Old Belvedere in Dublin. Nick is a club mate of mine. And Sean, I recently saw him playing. He's only 16-year-old. You notice he's wearing goggles. All squash players of junior age group under 19 have to wear goggles to play. Nick doesn't qualify as a junior, unfortunately. Sean, even though he's a young man, is immensely talented and one of the brightest prospects in the country. In fact, himself and Jack O'Flynn, who's also 16, are vying for number one in the under 17 Irish ranking. Not sure which of them is ranked highest. I think Sean is at the moment. The two great players. I'll talk more about Sean later on. I got caught in traffic, so I was delayed the start. Sean leads one game to love. Sean, as you'll notice, is a Catogue. I remember seeing Sean maybe 3 years ago. It's a tough decision from the referee. I remember seeing Sean 3 years ago, running a young lad. He's only about half the size he is now, and what absolutely struck me was his brilliant movement, extraordinary, the grace and subtlety of his movement. I'd actually never seen anyone of his age move as well as he did. Nick getting slightly annoyed at himself. Again, it's very difficult when Sean plays at a huge pace. Great depth from Sean. There's a slight contact with the racket. Sean's followed through on Nick and he apologized. Actually, what I really liked about the last time I saw Sean and Jack O'Flynn playing was the superb discipline they had and the politeness they showed. That's a lovely drop.
7-3 again to Murphy. Murphy leads 2 games to love.
2 games to love. So we're settling into a night squash. We have games going on all through the evening. Just trying to look at the schedule. At 6:30, Elliot Kelly is playing Gordon Harper. Elliot's a young lad I'm very familiar with. Another lovely lad. I'll talk more about him later. And then Rachel McNulty is playing Anne McConnell. Sorry, it's very small writing. And then at 8 o'clock, we have the number one seed, Sean Conroy, is playing David Noon from Galway in the first round of the men's. And, 8:30 is Michael Craven and Gavin Lestrange. That should be an absolutely cracker. I would expect Sean Conroy to beat David, even though David's a lovely player. But Michael and Gavin at 8:30 are colleagues. They both play in Sutton. They would have played each other right through the years. I would think they're both probably about 17, 18 years of age and amazingly talented. I've actually had the pleasure of being beaten by Gavin's father on more than one occasion. So I'm just glad I'm only looking at his son play. So anyway, Sean Murphy in this game is the number one seed in the men's B section. Nick is 16 seed. That's fairly harsh, I would have thought, on him. But as far as I understand, the players who win the first round of their matches in the B section then move in and play in the A section tomorrow to give them an opportunity of playing with players that would be deemed to be a higher standard, to try and give everybody an opportunity to move up to national rankings as quickly as possible. So that's all going to unfold tomorrow. But for the moment, let's enjoy 16-year-old Sean Murphy from Mount Pleasant Club, two games to love up on Nick Woods, and enjoy the quality of squash that these two players can provide. Yes, for those who haven't played, you saw Nick saying "ah" there, you heard him. Basically, when he played the ball back, he played it across his, basically too near his own body for his opponent to play. Oh, that's a beautiful drop. As Nick clapped on his own racket to acknowledge. But basically, if you play a ball that prevents your opponent from striking, it is actually a point against you in squash. So the referee, Peter, gave a stroke to Sean in that case. There's deception. Nick had begun to move to the right and was wrong-footed. There's a lovely lob. Oh, what a brilliant counter. That's brilliant play. Brilliant sequence, a beautiful lob, and then a magnificent drop counter, which is you rarely play off a lob. Interesting. Sean was giving out to himself even before the ball had hit out of court. The red line at the top. The ball must stay within the red line at the top for those who don't understand the game. And he realised he had overcompensated in lobbing and had given the point away. 5-1, he's comfortably in control. As I said, just to be on court with someone of his talent is a joy. That's a lovely tight ball. What we mean by a tight ball is a ball that is almost glued to the sidewall as it comes down, and it's impossible to get the racket to it. It's a sort of hit and hope of break your racket in the process sort of problem. So keeping the ball as tight to the wall is the preferred option. Oh, that's a great shot from Nick. Absolutely super. Three five. Nick seemed confused about the score. Oh, that is brilliant. Basically, that is not an accident. Sean, in playing that shot, deliberately played it off the front wall to hit the nick just where the wooden floor and the wall join. It's called a nick, and if the ball gets tight in there, it doesn't bounce through and often slides out. I get maybe 1 in 200 of them. Sean Murphy obviously has a much higher percentage. So Sean is cruising comfortably towards a 3-love win, but it'd be a very good experience for Nick. Nick is actually the number one player in Old Belvedere Club in Sean made a mistake there in Dublin here. And wouldn't be playing someone at the level that Sean is able to play at very often. So it's a huge learning experience for him. Oh, hard luck, Nick. He saw the opportunity. But again, the problem is when you're playing someone as good as Sean, you have to hit as close to the tin as possible. And that's running the risk, of course, of hitting it down. Because if it's anywhere too far up, Sean can do so much with it. Accordingly, acknowledges it bounced twice before he got to it. 10-4, in a match fall, as Peter says. That's a sad way to finish. But Nick acknowledged it was the right call from the referee. So, Sean Murphy, the number one seed in the B section, wins 3 games to 11. And will progress comfortably into the top grouping. But I must admit, when I looked at the seeding, I was quite surprised that Sean wasn't seeded in the top 16. But at this early time of the year, they haven't had the opportunity with so few tournaments to properly qualify the ranking.